Hello students, today we will continue with chapter number 7, Hydrogen. In the last class, I taught you the laboratory method of preparation of hydrogen by the usage of zinc and hydrochloric acid. So there are some important points in relation to that which you need to know. Children, why is zinc used or why is zinc preferred to any other metal in the laboratory method of preparation of hydrogen? The first reason, zinc is cheap in comparison to other metals such as calcium or magnesium. Okay, so it is preferred to other metals. Moreover, zinc, it contains traces of copper, okay, minute traces of copper as impurities. It acts as catalyst, okay, and it speeds up the reaction. Other metals such as potassium, sodium or calcium, they react violently with acid or water, okay, so they are not preferred. Metal lead is also not preferred in the laboratory method of preparation of hydrogen, because when lead reacts with sulfuric acid or hydrochloric acid, it forms insoluble coating of lead chloride or lead sulfate, okay, which further stops the reaction. It prevents the reaction from taking place. So we prefer zinc over any other metal in the laboratory method of preparation of hydrogen. Now let us learn about the preparation of hydrogen by the Bosch method. Okay, Bosch method process of preparation of hydrogen. In the Bosch method of preparation of hydrogen, okay, first of all, steam is passed over the hot coke around the temperature 1000 degree Celsius. When steam is passed over the hot coke, it leads to the formation of water gas. Water gas, which is a mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen. In the next step, this steam is mixed with water gas and it is passed over heated iron oxide and chromium oxide around the temperature 450 to 500 degrees Celsius, which lead to the formation of carbon dioxide and hydrogen gas. This reaction is exothermic reaction, so large amount of heat energy is liberated. Okay, in the next step, carbon dioxide is removed by passing the mixture of carbon dioxide and hydrogen through caustic potash or cold water. This carbon dioxide reacts with caustic potash, thereby forming potassium carbonate and water. Or when carbon dioxide, this mixture is passed through cold water, carbon dioxide reacts with water, thereby forming carbonic acid, and the hydrogen is left behind. The hydrogen gas which we obtain, it may still contain some traces of unreacted carbon monoxide. Okay, it may have the unreacted carbon monoxide. So this unreacted carbon monoxide can be removed by passing the mixture through a solution of ammonical copper chloride solution. Okay, this ammonical copper chloride, it dissolves carbon monoxide gas, okay, and forms an additional compound. Okay, and hydrogen gas is left